In today's video, we will be discussing what is an index in Python, how are elements indexed, indexing notation, example for indexing, reverse or negative index. If you are interested, then keep on watching. Hey champions, welcome back to this channel. Today's motivating words are, don't worry about failures, worry about the chances you miss when you don't even try. I hope that was enough to pull you up today. You can subscribe to this channel for more such videos. Without any further delay, let us get started with the video. Python strings are an array of bytes, and to access an individual element from this array, we need to know its position. This position is called an index, and the process of accessing an element using its index is known as the process of indexing. If you want to learn more about Python strings, then we have a separate video which we have linked in the description box. Coming back to the topic, an index is an integer value that can be both negative or positive. In Python, the index of the very first element is always 0. Now that we know what an index is, let's see how our elements are indexed. For this, we will consider the string hello. In Python, the first letter from the left has an index of 0. That is, h in our string is the very first letter from the left and will have an index of 0. Likewise, the second letter from the left, which is e, in our case has an index of 1. The third and the fourth letter have indexes of 2 and 3 and so on. Observe how the last letter of the string will always be indexed as total letters in the string minus 1. Now that we know the index of each element, let's see how to retrieve an element based on its index. To grab an element from the string, the indexing notation is used, which contains square brackets and a number to indicate the position of the element to be indexed in the string. Let us take an example to better understand it. We have a variable named myString and a string learning champion is assigned to it. Let's suppose I want to retrieve the character g from it using the indexing notation. Using the concept explained above, we can see that the index of g is 7. Now, when I write myString 7, Python returns g as the output. In the second example, I want to index the 9th element of the string. For that, I am using the indexing notation and have written myString 9. Once executed, Python will return the character c as the output. Easy peasy, right? You just have to mention the index of the letter you want to access in square brackets and Python will get that element for you. Now moving on to the last topic of the video, which is the negative index. The index we have studied so far is also known as the positive index. It references elements from left to right. A negative index is just the opposite of a positive index. It references elements from right to left and has a negative sign before the actual index. It is worth noting that the negative index always starts from minus 1, or we can say that the very first element from the right has an index of minus 1. Let's understand it using the string hello. The first letter from the right, which is O, is assigned an index of minus 1. The second letter from the right, which is L, is assigned an index of minus 2. Third and fourth elements will have the index as minus 3 and minus 4, and so on. An example will make it simpler to understand. Let's now try to access a character from myString using a negative index. I have written myString minus 1, and as you can see, Python has returned n, which is the very first element from the right of the string. In summary, a positive index references elements from left to right and starts from 0, while the negative index references elements from right to left and starts from minus 1. Now let us try a new scenario where we put the total length of the string as our index. Since our string has 17 characters in total, let's put 17 as the index and see what does Python returns. After execution, it has given us string index out of range error. I know you must be thinking that it should have returned n, which is the last letter of our string. But this is an error because the index in Python starts from 0 and not from 1. So any string that has n letters will have the last index as n minus 1 and not n. Hence, in our scenario, the last index will be 16 and not 17. So when we index the 16th letter from the string, it gave us n, which indeed is the last element. That's it for today's video. I hope this video helped you understand indexing in strings better. You can share your thoughts or questions in the comment box. Subscribe for more such videos. Bye and meet you in the next one.